We now understand that inflammation is a response that brings leukocyte and plasma molecules to sites of infection or tissue damage. The principal effects are an increase in blood supply, an increase in vascular permeability to large serum molecules, and enhanced migration of leukocytes across the local vascular endothelium and in the direction of the site of inflammation. There are mainly three phases of inflammatory response: the fluid phase, the cellular phase, and the healing phase. Now, what happens in the fluid phase? Let us look at a picture. In this picture, the bacteria is entered within the cell by a knife, at the point of the knife. So, the three phases, the details of the three phases can be summarized here. Fluid phase generally involves the chemical mediators. Bradykinin, produced in the kidney, causes pain and vasodilation. Histamine is released by mast cells, effect vasodilation and smooth muscle contraction. Prostaglandin, a lipid, is released by somatic and mast cells, and this causes vasodilation. Mast cell produces heparin, which is an anticoagulant. Leukocytes produce leukotrienes, which has a squeezing effect on capillaries and causes bronchial constriction. Serotonin, released by platelets, causes vasodilation. Histamine, released by basophils, also causes vasodilation. Also, there is the complement system. Now, this complement system has almost 20 serum proteins that bind to antibody in an ordered sequence or cascade. To mention, C3A interacts with mast cells and causes release of histamine. C3B enhances phagocytosis by coating called opsonization. Now, what is opsonization? Opsonization is the deposition of opsonins. Opsonization is the deposition of opsonins, a substance that promotes the phagocytosis of antigens by binding to them on an antigen, thereby promoting a stable adhesive contact with an appropriate phagocytic cells. C5A is chemotactic for neutrophils. Also, the mast cells secrete leukocytosis promotion factor, or LPF, that is chemotactic for neutrophils. This sort of action is followed by hemostasis. There are 12 clotting factors in the serum. It gets activated when they leave the circulatory system. Prothrombin produces thrombin and fibrinogen produces fibrin, both of which form the clot. Now we come to the cellular phase. Here we can see the clot formations. The cellular phase involves phagocytic cell infiltration. As a part of this phase, low pH kills microbes. Macrophages attack escaping microbes. Body temperature increases, IL-1, that is interleukin-1, starts functioning. Specific immunity begins here. Now, at last, it is the healing phase. This is the repair or the healing phase. This phase starts when fibroblast cells produce beta interferon. Lymphokines signal the immune system to stop. Fibroblasts proliferate and produce collagen fibers. Macrophage also produces collagen, and finally, intact connective tissue reforms.